And it's a funny thing, Coach, and we said it sort of half-jokingly, tongue-in-cheek, that your team, to some degree, for whatever reason, lost its mojo after a hard-fought, close win at SFA, and you got it back tonight against them.
I wish we'd have played them back-to-back.
That would have been nice.
Might not have lost our mojo. You know, it's funny. Basketball, all sports, but basketball is a funny game. It's such an emotional game of runs, and when you kind of get down – it's hard sometimes to get out of the funk, and coaches try everything. You know, you watch an inspirational video. You'll have a hard practice. You do a loose ball drill, diving on the floor. You can do a lot of different things. But usually it never gets corrected until the team wants to correct it. And, you know, when we got back off of our trip on Monday, our guys, they wanted to have a meeting without the coaches. And they met for a while, and then they wanted to have a meeting in the afternoon without the coaches. And so whatever was said, and I didn't ask, and I don't really care. It's a thing between them. But it's funny when you kind of clear the air and your mind's in the right place, how well you can play. And I thought tonight everybody played with passion and energy, unselfish, and they just did the things it takes to be a winning basketball team.
You know, we talked about it on the broadcast, Coach, but, you know, people at home probably take for granted. It's like, oh, you got a 20-point lead, you know, everything's good. Sometimes playing that big lead, we've talked about it before, is tough. Your team came out, I thought, and responded really well in the beginning of the second half.
You know, we told these guys that Stephen F. Austin was 20 down to Baylor and came back and won. They were 20 down to Abilene Christian and came back and won. So we knew what they were capable of. They're so explosive, especially with Harris and Bogues. And what I thought we did is, you know, we made a couple of silly mistakes, kind of let them have some opportunities, but then we kind of settled down and ran our offense well and then just got some big baskets, big timely baskets. I know Eddie Kailud had a couple of big ones to kind of stretch the lead back out and make it insurmountable. But we were certainly leery of them, and I thought we played, you know, accordingly, and which is good because you want to be a great closing team.
Hayden was great on the defensive end tonight and scored 9 points for you. Set the tone, obviously, with some blocks, and a couple other guys got in the mix on that as well. And you did it down a man tonight, too, with Matthew Montesier out. And I was a little concerned going in, honestly, because of the way that Harris can score. And I know Monty is one of your best, if not your best, on-ball defenders, and yet you were able to get it done without him.
Well, I thought Thatch Unruh had a great defensive game, especially the first half. He just did an outstanding job. And the thing that Thatch does, he plays good position. And, you know, Harris is a guy who doesn't shoot it great, and he loves to drive the ball. So Thatch understands that, played the angles well. I thought he got a little tired, but even our switches were good. I thought our bigger guys bothered him some, you know. And the thing is, you know, if Bogues goes 5 for 17 and Kayvon Harris goes 9 for 16, that's about as good a job as you can do on those guys. And so I was real pleased with the defensive effort. And you hold Stephen F. Austin to 40% shooting, you know, you got to have a chance.
Yeah, and you hold them to 29 in the first half, which is great. And, I mean, it took them forever to get to the 50-point mark, so it was a lot of fun. So now, again, you know, you love the win and then back on track maybe, but you got to hit the reset button and go again on Saturday against an Abilene Christian team that's trying to figure it out, and they were in a dogfight tonight. We were doing a little scoreboard watching because it's going to be a log jam at 6 wins after this one. There were a couple other teams that had lost, so there are a bunch of teams piling up there in that position, everybody fighting for a spot in Katy. And as we've talked about a million times, just get there and anything can happen this year.
Well, they wouldn't listen to us and take 10 teams, you know, and now they're going to pay the price for it because it's going to be a mess, and there are going to be some schools that are going to be very disappointed. But, you know, what we need to do is just take care of the next game, which is Abilene Christian, senior day here. You know, we got three guys we're going to hate to say goodbye to, but we have to nonetheless. And we just need to be ready to play again. And I told the guys in there just now, Justin, I said, don't worry about the next three and Katy and all that stuff. Let's enjoy what we did tonight and try to play that way again. I think the most important thing for us is that we play well these last three games because we need to understand who we're going to be in the future. And, yes, I want to get there for Thatch and Tanner and Jordan, but I think the bigger thing is I want to play well. And if we do that, just like tonight, you see our talent, a guy like Kaleem Bennett. He's playing hard and playing with energy. He's special. And Eddie Kailud, and those guys are freshmen, and what they need to do is go into this offseason knowing they can have some success. And so that's why these games coming up for me are important, because I think if we play well, the wins will come.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah.
Tonight.
That's what it looks like.
I remember that team.
That team.
I saw that team play here before.
Yeah, about 6 weeks ago.
That was fun.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, Coach, we'll see you Saturday. Let's do it again.
Appreciate it.
All right.